Economists are interested in choice making. What goods to buy, what retirement plan to choose, what jobs to take. But the most important choice we make for our society is the political leaders we choose. Voting is the way that we make those choices. And coming up with a good voting system is a real mathematical challenge. I also like the fact that this intellectual puzzle is important to our society. Voting determines who will lead us forward and what policies we will enact as a people. Under the current system, the winner of the election is simply the candidate who gets the most votes, which is fine if there are only two candidates, because the candidate with the most votes will have a majority. But if there are many candidates running for office, the candidate with the most votes might actually just have a tiny fraction of the overall total, meaning that the overwhelming majority of voters voted for someone else. That doesn't seem democratic, and ranked choice voting solves that problem. Voters have the opportunity to go beyond just picking one candidate, picking their favorite candidate. They get to rank the candidates. And so you will have a say in all of the choices that matter. So if your first choice gets eliminated, now your second choice comes into play. It actually makes life easier for voters. It's been used in Australia for over 100 years, and it's now being used in quite a few American locales as well. One advantage that the U.S. has over many other democracies is actually the power to change incrementally. And that allows us to experiment, see which experiments work, and then embrace the successful ones.